And also I simply encourage you to run away from Islam. The Islam you brought from Afghanistan
is the way of dignity, of the way that a person can live under the Islam. Islam, what's Islam? Islam is from Salam. Salam means peace.
According to who?
According to who
Islam means peace?
The word itself, Islam, Islam came from Salam.
According to who?
According to who? According to everyone.
No, that's a lie. Islam means submission. Islam means submission. Bring your evidence that Islam means peace.
That's one event in his life. You shouldn't generalize it, you know.
Sorry?
That's one event in his life, Abu Bakr. We are all humans. Something like this can happen. We have emotional situations in which occurs. No one is perfect, you know.
So,
he has
sorry,
once
so, sorry, sorry, I'm just trying to understand. This is the statement Abu Bakr did once in his lifetime.
Okay,
therefore, we shall just turn blind eye and ignore. What are you gonna do if the followers of Islam is using this to justify?
Believe me, they don't do it because
they
the
do.
History of
they
Tabari,
do. They do.
You
so,
have to check up the translation.
So here's the huge article. There is a huge article. Where is it? This one. Justifying people to be killed through jihad because simply it is acceptable in Islam if you are insulting someone. That's the example Abu Bakr sets it, okay? That's a huge article here.
You should prioritize other sources first, you know?
So, that was the first Tabari. This is the second one. This is the Muhammad, Messenger of Allah is talking, okay? From Sunni sources. Can you read it to me? If you hear someone boasting in an arrogant manner of his tribal lineage, then tell him to bite.
Look, those you have to always be aware that in those sources you have to compare with other sources first before making a general statement. Muslims are very sensible with such sources, which was related by Al-Musnad Ahmad.
So it is mentioned in Ahmad, classified as a Hassan, okay? And then Islam QA is justified using such actions, okay? So it is ugly action. It is ugly saying, if you are Muslim, you should be ashamed of it right now. Are you Muslim? Not laugh at it. You should gülmemelisin. Gülmene hiçbir gerek yok.
Evet.
Çok çok çirkin, çirkin en çirkin bir şey.
Bu, hani,
English.
Şöyle bir şey anlamı. You have to understand that the general message we get to know from the first primary sources, not to curse in the first place, not to, you know, you don't get this message anywhere in the Islamic sources. But these
okay.
were collectors. Tabari was a historical.
Okay, so let's hold the hands. Can you hold the page? Okay. 5 seconds silent for the funeral of Abu Bakr that you are burying him right now. You throw him under the bus, he's gone. Okay, now focus. Let's get rid of this. Tell me why you are Muslim. Tell me why you are Muslim. Why are you Muslim?
I'm not used to this kind of religion. Let me think first. I need to give it
for the first thing. I'll give you time to think. How old are you, sir?
23.
Have you ever seen your father is beating your mother?
Never.
No. If you see this gentleman is beating his wife, what would you do?
I would maybe advise him.
Can you look at me when you speak to me?
To, yeah.
Because I can't hear well.
I would advise him to not to beat his wife.
So you would advise him to not beat his wife. What else you would do?
Maybe I would interfere.
You would step in.
Yeah.
Okay. If Allah is telling you that you have right to beat your wife, what would you do?
I would try to understand in the context.
Okay, let's turn the context.
You know, there is a professor. I'm attending the Goethe University in Frankfurt am Main, in Germany. Okay. and I'm studying Islamic studies and also English studies. And
sir,
there is
I want you to focus.
Angelika Neuwirth, maybe you know her. Angelika Neuwirth, she's very famous in Germany.
I know.
And she
let me focus. No, no, no, no.
I want you to. After I finish, you can.
What is your name?
My name is Michael.
Michael.
Yeah. After I finish, okay. Just you can talk. So she said, looking at the context, looking at societal structure. The first was like a relief for the women in such a time. In the time when she was treated as an object, okay? She was treated as... Women were treated as an object, okay? And Islam gave many more rights to women. If you transfer it to today, that would mean that many things in Islam has to be, you know, thought over again, and the principles behind it have to be understood. It's very common knowledge at university we don't discuss things like this, because there is a transfer from the history, from the context, from the social context to today.
Let me respond. I am sorry to...
Did you understand? I heard what you said. Did you understand me?
I heard what you said. Okay. I am very sorry to hear at age 23,
yeah,
you are already trying to justify certain teachings. That is very much I am disturbed by. First of all, Islam doesn't give women any right which they didn't have before. Okay, that's a huge lie. And I am sorry, at university you've been lied, my brother. Police removed my brother, just a moment.
Derek filmed everything. Okay, Derek, my camera, he's filmed it all. They put him in the van and took him away.
Who?
The older guy.
Oh, the other older guy, yeah.
They put him in the van and took him away, Derek said.
What?
To be Islamic teacher. Okay. Can you tell me about Khadija?
I've told you that she was the first wife of the Prophet.
Okay, so she was the first wife of Muhammad. Can you compare Khadija's time versus the wives of other Muhammad? Was Khadija covered up?
I'm not sure about that.
Answer is no.
Can you prove it?
Because covering entered the Islamic world after the death of Khadija.
Came up. You say it, so you're claiming that covering
Surah 33 verse 59.
Before that there was no hijab, no covering.
Covering stepped in. You are going to be Islamic teacher, how come you don't know very basics? So Surah 33 verse 59, covering comes so that you cover, that you don't get abused.
Before that there was no covering?
No.
No at all, in the Arabic Peninsula.
The reason covering comes because Umar sees one of Muhammad's wives. She's large and big at night. She's like checking the woman, he's checking the woman's out. He goes to Muhammad and then says, we need to cover the wives, otherwise I'm recognizing what your wife is doing. Suddenly Allah steps in and then gives this verse of covering. So you cover that you don't get abused. Muslim woman needs to cover, Muslim man don't abuse them. Khadija did not cover. Her right of freedom to dress up what she wants to have is being taken away with the teachings of Muhammad. She was able to ask Muhammad to marry her. What happened? Islam stepped in and then take that right away from Muslims. Oh, like,
I would like to see the sources first.
You give me the sources, since you are disagreeing with me.
I haven't graduated yet, and you know, I'm focusing more on methodology and stuff.
Let me ask you a very basic question.
I'm interested in it.
Someone who is training to be Islamic teacher, how are you handling the child wife?
The child what?
Child wife, child marriage.
Aisha, so there's...
Sorry, what is the name of the child wife?
Aisha.
Aisha. How old was Aisha when Mohammed had sex with her?
She was young, she was young. I know
how
discussed.
Old?
I have, you know,
how
there's
old?
Always the same discussions.
How old was she?
I don't know. You have to look up the sources.
So you are going to be, are you sure you are training to be
a
teacher?
I'm not going to be a professor at university. I'm going to teach in school.
So you are going to teach in school? You don't even know the basics of Islam?
Students who are Muslim. I know the basics.
Oh, so you are going to, what are you going to say to the Muslim man?
Yeah.
Imagine I am your student. Teacher, can my father have sex with your child?
I would say no.
You would say no?
Yeah.
What is your justification for that?
It will be probably some 10 lessons or so, and we will take that, let me say, issue from many perspectives and come to a conclusion together with the class.
Okay.
And then I will let the students decide for what they are decide for what they are deciding for themselves. This is true.
Okay.
Okay.
So you will let students decide if it is true or not. Let's do very basic.
Okay.
Are you a Prophet Muhammad?
I guess no.
You guess no. Okay. We can figure that out. Like, it's not that difficult to figure that out.
Okay.
Are you Allah? No, you've got two shins. Are you Allah?
I guess not.
You are not Allah. While the word of Allah orders you to divorce the child who you had sex with, who do you think you are? Lying to the Muslim students and telling them, oh, we can make a decision which is acceptable. Who do you think you are, overriding the word of Allah?
It's not about overriding the verse of Allah, it's just shedding new light on the verse of Allah, you know?
Okay, share the light here. 65-4. So you are going to be Islamic teacher, you don't even know the basics about Islam, but
basics.
You know how to lie and deceive Muslims.
I don't have the light.
And it's not funny. Gülünecek bir şey yok gerçekten.
Çünkü bilmiyorum.
So, when, did your prophet made a mistake when he climbed the top of a child?
See those things like a frame, okay? There's like a framing in a society,
context.
In a context. You know, there's a framing.
What is the context of this? So, while the word of Allah was existed from the beginning to end, what is the context of this?
So
explain it to me. Actually, before that, can you just explain me what the verse is saying?
Sorry, before I go into, I don't want to go into this verse right now. You can't just take one verse and make like a generalization from it. There's a context in which it was, you know.
I am not taking one verse and making generalization of it. I am asking you, who is going to be the Islamic teacher? I am asking you to explain this to me. You are going to be teacher. I am sure you all studied this, and you are justifying. Explain it to me.
I'm not going to be a theology teacher. I'm not going to.
You are going to teach Muslims about Islam.
I think you don't want to understand me. I'm trying to say something to you.
You are going to teach this to Muslim children. So, how are you going to deal? How are you going to deal with this verse when your Muslim child student says, I am going to use this, my father is using this verse to have sex with my neighbor's child. What are you
going
to do?
Do you really think that one student is going to tell me this? Do you really think that?
Yeah. Yeah. Imagine that happened. What are you going to say?
I can't imagine it because it probably
won't
happen.
It's not going to happen anyway.
Yeah.
It's only happening in your side. How many children have been abused by your church every day?
Islamic grooming gangs, see? People are screaming out for Islamic grooming gangs again.
About children sex,
so how do you justify this?
Talk about your church. How many children been abusing the church every day, on a daily basis?
I don't want to use her methods.
Yeah.
I don't want to use her methods. Like,
sir, can, priest sir, on a daily basis,
sir,
the children,
can you explain this
children
to me? Like, what is your own reading of this?
I have told you, you know, I will shed some lights on it.
Yeah.
And we will look at the hadith, look at the
Prophet's
life, look at the verses, and then we will come to a conclusion.
Okay, so can we do that now?
I'm not ready to do that now, mate.
Why?
Because I haven't prepared, because I haven't looked at the evidences, you know.
So,
I've got
the tafsir with me. I've got the tafsir with me.
Teacher, he's not going to rape the child. It's only happening here in England.
Oh, well, Muhammad raped the child.
No,
Muhammad raped the woman. Maybe he's better than his prophet. That's absolutely fine. I can't say much about it. And in Islam, raping is okay anyway. I've got the tafsir. So tafsirs identified this as you are divorcing them while they are in young age. They are just a child who is being developing. So I guess my question still stands. If you are going to teach Muslims about Islam, and right now you are studying to be Islamic teacher, how are you going to handle this verse?
I have told you that I have
I'm not satisfied with
it. I don't have evidence for it.
You don't need to.
How does it make you feel as a man?
You don't need to be satisfied with my I'm not here to satisfy you.
Why not?
Okay.
You can't even give me a very basic answer.
I'm trying to give you a message. I have told you.
What is the message?
I have already given you the message. What I'm telling you right now is, look at the principles which are, you know, conveyed by the Quran before you choose and cherry pick those verses. Look at
show
the principles
me another,
first.
Show me another principle with the, in the Quran. It states that you cannot marry with a child, or you cannot have sex with a child.
Yeah, as I have told you, until the 19th century, you could do it in America, in the modern state, in the Enlightenment as well.
Is that your justification?
It's not the justification. Your prophet.
So, do you believe your prophet followed the Western law and then did that to Aisha?
Our prophet didn't live in postmodern
times. Do you think Allah followed the Western law and then asked Muhammad to practice all those kind of things?
So you are assuming that
I'm asking you the law of Allah
is like living in the postmodern era, and you're treating him with the myth, with the teachings of the postmodern era.
So, you know, do you think the teachings of Muhammad should be in 7th century?
No, not all. The principle.
Okay, which
we
ones?
Should
so, which teachings of Muhammad should be buried in 7th century?
We should learn from his principles.
He has no principle at all.
The manifestations
so, which
of
teachings of Muhammad should be buried in 7th century? Which teachings of Muhammad should be buried in 7th century? Child marriage? Put that in 7th century? Yes or no?
That's a social cultural context.
Should you leave the child marriage in 7th century? You leave it.
I don't leave it there. But that was a specific matter to that time. It was a specific matter to the time of the 20th century. But now the culture has changed.
Okay.
And it
got
can
it.
Change yeah. again to
got
that.
It. Got it. Okay, got it. So, do you think in that case, this Quran, it was only for 7th century.
No, it was not only for 7th century. There are teachings and
so should I get rid of this verse for you?
You don't need to get rid of it. You don't need
no,
to get
we
rid
still
of
keep it.
It is
the verse which talks about divorcing
there,
a child
there are timeless
should
messages.
Still stay
there,
in the Quran.
There are timeless messages.
You take in one case, there is hundreds of
the,
cases.
The verse which talking about the divorcing
maybe,
a child should that stay in the Quran?
After 300 years, it will be needed again.
Okay, maybe in 300 we will need it. Therefore, we keep it in the Quran.
Why don't you go and stop the children being abused in this church anyway? I told you many times.
Why don't you go and give your private part to Muhammad?
We have this issue one time with the Prophet and explain for you. Today in the 21st century, hundreds of children has been abused and raped
don't
in the
cry.
Church.
Don't cry, baby. Don't cry, baby. Don't cry, baby.
You just don't like the fact. That's the problem.
Don't
Look,
cry, baby.
Look, is moving now.
Don't cry, baby. Don't cry, baby.
It's too old anyway.
So
why don't you go and
don't cry, baby.
I see now. How many children been abused in this country?
Where is the
thousands, millions.
Over 300,000 girls are victims of grooming gangs.
Abuse and touches.
What grooming gangs? Yeah? Islamic grooming gangs. What is their reference? Surah 65, actions of Muhammad as well as Surah 65. So, should I get rid of Surah 65 verse 4?
But Surah 65, in which century was referring to an age?
I have already responded to you.
Okay, we get rid of it. So now let's deal with the other one where you talked about the rights are given to the woman.
I leave you with her, but ask her the question. Where she go, there is about 10 or 15 children being abused.
Can
you need
to
report
to
it to the police. Like, instead of helping the priest, you know?
Can you read this for me?
That's what you should do.
Sana kolayges, ben gidiyorum.
Bundan niye kaçıyorsun ki? Hayır, bir sürü yalan söyledin. Bir sürü yalan söyledin. Sana da okuduğun üniversitede yalan söylüyorlar. Sen de gelecek nesillere yalan söylemesini öğreniyorsun.
Ben gerçekten bazı şeyleri öğrenmek için anlamak istiyorum. Evet, Müslüman ailede doğdum ama üniversitede bak işte Alman profesörler var. Bunu söyleyen kadın da Müslüman değil. Ve bize birçok eseri önümüze koyup gösteriyorlar. Tamam bak, böyle bakabilirsin.
Kadınlar Allah'tan iyi geliyorlarsa çok güzel.
Buradan bakabilirsin.
Kadınlar Allah'tan iyilerse çok güzel. Because Allah onu söylemiyor. Allah onu söylemiyor. Muhammed onu yapmadı. Sana yalan söylendi. Sana hala yalan söyleniyor. Ve seni... They trained you to lie to the next generation. That is most dangerous thing, sir.
Anlamak için farklı filtreleri gösteriyorlar. Farklı filtrelerle Kur'an'ı nasıl sallayabiliriz? İslam tarihi nasıl anlayabiliriz? Fikirlerin nasıl geliştiğini nasıl anlayabiliriz? Ve işte içindeki hakikatin ve prensiplerin ortaya...
You know, you don't even have to pay for the university. I'll tell you how to make sense of Islam. Get rid of this book and get rid of all the teachings of Muhammad. Life will make sense and Islam, when it is not exist, it will make sense. And you don't have to pay for the university at all. That was free lesson for you. Görüşürüz. Apparently one of our brother is being removed from speaker's corner because lovely Muslims were in action. I'm just going to ask that to Mr. Policeman. Like I am concerned about him right now.
Okay. I'll find out, but I don't know what the circumstances
are. Okay, I'll wait. That's fine. I'll wait to hear from you.
Can I just finish doing this?
That's fine. I'll wait here. Yeah.
Okay. So right, so my colleague.
No, it's fine.